All right, so we'll just work as many questions as we can. As you can see, this is June 2021. And of course, you know that they repeat a lot of questions. Therefore, you know, answer as many questions as you can. All right, the particles in a gas have strong forces, very closely packed, can move in one in any direction, get larger. All right, so they can move in any direction. So your answer there is C. Okay. Just try to remember as well that, what would you say now? Multiple choice questions, generally speaking, they have two answers which make no sense and two which are close, and you need to decide between the two. You should never leave a multiple choice question blank, never. Even if you have to guess, you can guess and get the answer right. So don't leave it blank, it makes no sense. Okay, so remember, two which are far-fetched, which make no sense, two which are close together. So particles of a gas can move in any direction, right? Okay, cool. I need to take that off. Right, the mass number of an element is the number of protons and neutrons. So where's that? C. And I should really go across to four. Sulfur and oxygen are in the same group of the periodic table because they have the same number of electrons on their outer shell. All right. And then for five, now refers to the diagram which represents the symbol of a positive ion, which of the following pairs represents the number of neutrons. So it would be 20 neutrons and the number of electrons, it would be 20 minus 18. So the number of neutrons is 20, the number of electrons is 18, so that's D. If you're not clear, why I get something asked. The arrangement of electrons in an atom is like this. X is 285, Y is 286, so they're both non-metals. Non-metals have 4 to 8 valence electrons, so your answer there is B.
The 8?
What?
I thought it was 4 to 7.
4 to 8. Noble gases are also non-metals.
Oh, okay.
All right. An element X has 8 electrons in its outer shell. Which of the following diagrams possible isotope of X? It has 8 electrons, which means that it also has 8 protons. Right. So which of these would be, which of the following diagrams are possible isotopes of X? Okay. All right. So clearly this one. So the answer is A. Don't need to look at anything else, because they should have the same number of protons as X. So X has 8 electrons, the isotope would also have 8 protons. Okay, so from which of the following substances can a solid be obtained by the process of sedimentation? And that is suspensions, when you leave them to settle. The mass of 1 mole of atoms, the mass of 1 mole of atoms of an element refers to the quantity of one atom of element, an element which contains that number of atoms, element which occupies 24 at STP, 24 is for RTP, an element which combines complete with 10 grams. Okay, so your answer is B, an element which contains 6.20 times 10 to the 23. That's Avogadro's number. Which of the following terms describe calcium chloride? Calcium chloride is a giant ionic structure. Okay. All right, which of the following diagrams illustrate the course of an exothermic reaction? In an exothermic reaction, the products have less energy than the reactants. So you just look for the one with less energy than the reactants, and that is A. Item 11 refers to the types of substance, refer to the following types of substances, alkali, base, et cetera, et cetera. Which of the following substances above can be described described as an oxide of a metal, and that's a base. Even though alkalis are bases, alkalis are the hydroxides of metals, and that's why you would get it wrong if you say alkali. All right. Which of the following ions requires the largest number of moles of electrons to liberate one mole of it? So this has to do with electrolysis. And basically, you're looking at how many electrons you need to add or subtract from these species for them to become neutral. The answer is actually A. a lot of students tend to choose aluminum because it says 3+. And since this is 2-, they think it's 2-, but it's not. It's actually 4 electrons. Let me show you why it's 4 electrons. Where are the thing? Let me show you why it's 4 electrons. It's 4 electrons because the oxygen is going to become oxygen gas. And since there are 2 oxygens over here, this is O2, this needs to be 2 as well. And since that's 2, the charge becomes -4. So this is going to be 4 electrons like so. And that's why that's the answer. A lot of students will get that wrong if they don't consider that. All right. So next thing, we proceed. An atom has 20 electrons. When it ionizes, it has the same electronic configuration as argon. All right, the mass concentration of potassium chloride is 60 grams. What is the mass of potassium chloride in 25 centimeters cube of solution? So we know that mass concentration or concentration is the amount of substance in 1,000 centimeters cube. So clearly, all you're doing right here is saying 60 grams is equal to 1,000 centimeters cube. Therefore, X is equal to 25. Do you have a calculator with you there? Because that's going to work out to be 25 times 60, which is 6 times 25 is 150, right? So that is basically 1,500 divided by 1,000, something like that. 1,500 divided by 1,000 is how much?
1.5,
you work it out with your calculator?
Yes.
Okay, so the answer is 1.5. All right, fine. 1.5. All right, so now we proceed, right? Which of the following elements exhibits allotropy, and that's carbon, you know, graphite, diamond, fullerenes, nanotubes. A solution having a pH of 1 will neutralize a solution of pH 4. No. React with zinc to produce hydrogen. Yes. Don't need to go any further once you get your right answer. All right. Item 16 refers to the following information. XY, double XY, atom number 333. Which two elements above, when combined, form mainly ionic compounds? So you're looking for a metal and a non-metal. So W and X, W and Y for sure, W and X as well. So you can look for any of those, W and Y, W or X. Now, notice here that they have W and X and they have W and Y. See, double X, double Y. So which one do you choose? Now, they did say in the question, mainly ionic compounds. All right, so let's see something here now. Double is lithium, so you have to think about it. X is going to be oxygen, and Y is going to be chlorine. So double and Y is going to form lithium chloride, and W and X is going to form lithium oxide. Which one of those is more ionic in nature? We would say that the lithium chloride is more ionic in nature. So double Y, right? So the answer would be B. Even though lithium oxide, which is double X, is ionic. But we're looking for the one which is mainly ionic or more ionic in nature. Okay. Which of the following oxides reacts with both acids and bases? So this is basically asking you for which of the oxides is amphoteric. Oxides of zinc, aluminium, and lead are amphoteric. So there is aluminum oxide. Your answer is C. Okay. Barium is below calcium in group 2 of the periodic table, which, when these two metals react with water, the main difference observed is the rate of reaction, of course, right? Not the type of gas involved, color, the product, or change in litmus, but the rate of reaction. Because barium is more reactive, it's going to be more vigorous. The number of shared electron pairs in methane is 4. So the answer there is A. Okay. Question 18, which of the following substances, when added to pure water, significantly increases the water's conductivity? So basically, you're looking for something which is very ionic in nature, okay? Something which is very ionic in nature, sodium chloride, C. Even though copper hydroxide and iron hydroxide are ionic species in nature, they are not as ionic or as polar as sodium chloride. And so therefore, when you add sodium chloride, the conductivity significantly changes. 22 refers to one mole of each of the following acids, H2SO4, and that one, which is diformate, I think. Which of the acids above would require more than one mole of sodium hydroxide for complete neutralization? We know one would definitely need more than one mole because remember, neutralization, you're replacing this hydrogen with sodium, and this has two hydrogens, so you're going to need two sodiums to replace it. Same thing for this one. The ethanoic acid only has one proton, which is this one, so it's only one sodium hydroxide for that. But this one has two protons, the H right there. So your answer is